Peace, it's Queen Yenn. Happy full moon. Just wanted to hop on real quick and give some pointers about this specific full moon and the energy that it comes with, that it is bringing. And it's bringing a lot of energy when it comes to emotions, you know. And so just wanted to give something to maybe have on your mind as we experience this full moon tonight. And as the full moon phase continues, you know, because we have three more days of this energy, and then we have the entire waning moon period that really still stores somewhat of this type of energy leading up to the new moon. And so when you think about emotions, just remember that emotions put things in motion. Emotions and your feelings are messengers. And so they are not the main thing to remember, is that emotions and feelings are not for you to hold on to. You know, it's not for you to use that as your anchor. Don't use your emotions as your anchor. Stay anchored in the reality of God, which is that, listen, everything at the end of the day is always working out in your favor. When things come to maybe shake up your emotions, so you feel a little sadness, you may feel some anger, anxiety, worry, any of those things that we can see as imbalanced, just know that those emotions or those feelings are coming as messengers. It's trying to tell you something. It might be telling you to take a U-turn. It might be telling you that this is not the way to go. It may be saying it's time for you to be still for a second and pay attention to what's happening around you. Pay attention to what the situation is unfolding. It may be a sign for you to get still, you know, and appreciate what's happening, even though maybe you are not in agreement or it's making you feel some type of way. Be the observer. Take yourself out of it. Don't be absorbed in it. Become the observer. And you will see, you know, as an observer, you will see, you know, better. You will start going, oh, wow, so it's not really what it seemed, or there's some silver lining in it, you know, because oftentimes when we absorb, we can't see the silver lining in it. We can't see the good or the God in it. And then also I want to say, you know, if it's the case where you just can't find yourself to really be in a place where you can be an observer and you are pretty absorbed, or you feel the feelings but you don't quite know why they're there, you don't know the lesson, you don't know what it is, and you can't quite figure it out, don't obsess over it. You know, always having your prayers, may my lessons be clear to me, you know, may my heart and mind be open so that I can see, so that I can hear, you know. May I always remember that I am divinely guided and provided for, so there is nothing to fear. You know, have that in your prayer. And, you know, may all of the lessons that's needed to be had on my behalf, may they be revealed to me. Put that in your prayers, and I guarantee that they will be, you know, one way or the other. But the main thing is, don't latch hold to those emotions. You know, let it flow. Always remember that life in divine, when you're in alignment, you are on your divine path, you are in a flow. That flow may be turbulent sometimes, but it's still flowing. It's not blocked up. And we block up when we hold on to emotions, when we don't let go, you know, when we don't let go. And that's, as my people say, let go and let God, you know, let the life force energy that created the worlds and that sustaining the worlds, let it do what it does. You know, that's why we call it by so many names. You know, this life force energy, this thing we call God, the creator, is the most merciful, the most gracious, you know, the master manifester, the expediter, you know. It's the truth, it's the light, it is peace, you know, it is healing, it is what it is, and it is truth, and it is love, and it is guidance, and it is our protection. And so when we stand firm on knowing that, and we move as if we know that, that's when we'll see things work out on our behalf without us having to without us having to really worry about it, you know, without us having to be so anxious about it or try to control it. You know, let go. That control may make you feel like you know, that it makes you feel better, but ultimately it even is subtly or clearly causing you anxiety and worry and all of those different things. So let it go so it can flow, you know, so you won't put up any energetic blockages and you can allow things to work themselves out in a divine way. All right, I hope this was impactful, resonant with you. Enjoy this full moon. I pray that I see you tonight on the meditation call. You can register for that at the link in bio. It is tonight, Monday, the 26th at 7:30 p.m. Eastern time. We will review the energy of this specific full moon. What is it calling for us to do? And we will do a grounding and aligning meditation and do an exercise that's in alignment with this specific super full moon energy. Okay, enjoy the rest of your moon day. Happy full moon. Peace.